Another popular movie, and this is just a fun movie, don't get me wrong, I'm not here to preach. I'm just here to remind you, it is yet another reminder how Hollywood will often use business guys to be the bad guys, which means all three of my next guests are the bad guys, commenting on the bad guys. They would be David Bahnsen, the Bahnsen Group CIO, Rebecca Walzer, Walzer Wealth Management, Adam Leshinsky, some of you not at all surprised that he falls into that territory. Adam, my own boy, it's very good to have you guys here doing something a little different, but I thought I'd have fun with it. But you know, Adam, I was thinking when these proposals of the president's right now to get this infrastructure package through tax increases on corporations and the wealthy, and it has such widespread support, it's because people really do dislike companies, really do dislike rich people. And this movie feeds the narrative that, yeah, you should. What do you think?
Well, first of all, Neil, Hollywood needs a villain, right? There has to be a villain. And we need to be honest with ourselves about the fact that big corporations in particular, in addition to doing a lot of great things like providing people jobs and being the engine of the economy, do a lot of bad things. They're polluters. They lay a lot of people off. They skirt their taxes by moving their companies to Switzerland or Ireland or wherever it is that they go. So these just like big government is vilified for the bad that it does from time to time, so are big corporations.
And Rebecca, be interested to hear your view on this. The common theme of the business guy, the bad guy, so you could always be suspicious of how he came upon his money. What do you think?
Yeah, Neil, it reminds me back to Terminator, The Rise of the Machines, or whatever that one was. It's the same thing over and over. Eventually, if we give too much power over to corporations, we'll become fascist, and they'll control the country. And we've actually seen a lot of that, especially with the last election cycle and post-election cycle, with them making a lot of decisions about what kind of American opinions would be able to remain standing on their platforms when we all thought it was free speech.
I'm just wondering where this goes. I think from a young age, people are conditioned to think suspiciously of companies. And I think Adam raises a good point. I mean, some of these you get the bad press that they have coming, but some of them don't. Most of them, I think, don't. And I don't like kids being indoctrinated on this thought that all guys in that business, in any business, are bad. When I raised this with my teenage son, he said, shut up and let's watch a movie. But what do you think of that?
Look, I don't think we're assessing the problem correctly. I don't agree with Adam that the reason is because some are good and create jobs, but there's a whole lot of polluters and bad ones out there too. There's good and bad teachers, there's good and bad parents, there's good and bad all sorts of things in society. The reason why businesses are particularly targeted in this regard is for one reason only: covetousness. We envy successful people. It's a moral condition. It's wrong. It's been going on since the Ten Commandments. And you and I talked on your show a long time ago, Neil. I wrote a whole book called Crisis of Responsibility about this very topic. It's because we don't have to be specific. The movies don't have to be specific about who did what wrong.
No, they don't.
We can just demonize all people that have more money than us. It's not good, and it needs to stop.
But we got to cool it. We got to cool it. Because, it's out of control.